from is your failure to turn to. If you don't accept Jesus Christ as the Lord of your life, hell will be your home. Can I get a witness up here? I feel you, Lord. Is it all right?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell your neighbors this, I ain't going to hell. Because of my relationship with Jesus Christ. So as he purposed to come to Jerusalem, he said all along his journey, the Holy Ghost witness that there's going to be bonds and afflictions waiting on you when you get to Jerusalem. In other words, they got a jail cell waiting for you, Paul. And they're going to afflict you when you get there. But what I like about it is the Holy Ghost had prepared him for everything that was around the corner that he could not see.
Yeah.
Anybody here glad for the Holy Ghost today?
Yeah.
How many know that the Holy Ghost will prepare you for things that you cannot see? I don't know about you, but I'm thankful today for the Holy Ghost. I know sometimes in the Baptist church we don't want to talk about the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
But I'm here to tell you we need him.
Yeah.
Notice I didn't say we need it, but we need him. We need the Holy Ghost. Because he is the one that makes a difference in our life.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you, baby, what makes you different from those people that are in the world? Somebody shout the Holy Ghost.
Yeah,
he calls you to be a prototype. He calls you to be one of a kind. There is nobody like you. They look like you, but they're not like you, because you got the Spirit of Christ living on the inside of you. Come on, tell somebody, there's nobody else like me. Is it not all right? I feel God over here. Can I get a witness up in here? And so I'm glad today, Russian, because of the Holy Ghost. Because there's some things around the corner that you cannot see. But the Holy Ghost will prepare you. He is your helper. He'll prepare you even though you can't see what is getting ready to happen. He'll get you stronger when you don't even think you need any strength. He'll make you wiser when you think you already know what's getting ready to happen. How many know, how many glad today of the Holy Ghost? Of the Holy Ghost will help you. Can I get a witness? I'm glad about that today, because there's some things that happens in my life that I didn't even see it coming. Can I get a witness? How many know that life just happens sometimes?
Yeah.
You don't even see life coming at you.
Yeah.
But you are able to take life blows because the Holy Ghost has prepared you. That's why when your loved one, amen, goes home to be with the Lord, you can make it because the Holy Ghost has prepared you. That's why when you have some trials and tribulations in your life, you can keep on keeping on because the Holy Ghost has prepared you. That's why when folk run your name down, stab you in your back, blast you on Facebook, tweet you about this or that, you can keep on standing because the Holy Ghost has already prepared you. Come on, give God a praise up in here for the Holy Ghost. Yeah. Yes. So here he is. Amen. The prophetic words of Amos said, Paul, they're going to bind you up and put you in jail everywhere he went. The Holy Ghost was telling him, get ready, get ready, get ready. There's bonds and afflictions and waiting on you in Jerusalem. But what I like about this brother was, even though he had some bad news, he did not allow bad news to deter him for what God has called him to do. Can I get a witness up in here? Can I get a witness here? How many know that you got to stay focused even though you may receive some bad news? Go tell somebody, I serve a God who is able to do exceeding and abundantly above all that I ask or think. No matter what comes my way, how many know that my God is an able God? Give somebody a high five and say, Lord, he is able. He cannot fail me. Can I get a witness? And so here he is. He says to them, but you know what? None of these things move me. Can I get a witness here? None of these things move me. Here's the first piece. He says, listen, Russell, be devoted to your call. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, be devoted to your call. In other words, get a whole lot of neon lights flashing, trying to get you to leave your calling. They come in all shapes, colors, and packages, trying to get you to leave your calling. Sometimes they show up rushing at 36, 24, 36. But you gotta say, I'm not gonna be moved by that. Sometimes it shows up with gleam like silver and gold to tip you. But you gotta tell that silver and gold gleam, my God, I got a Philippians 4:19 mentality, but my God shall supply all of my needs. Can I get a witness up in here? If you know God will supply your needs, shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, my God will. I'm not talking about he might, but I'm saying that my God will. I heard somebody say it like this, won't he will? Can I get a witness up in here? Give somebody a high five and say, won't he will? God will supply all of my needs. Can I get a witness? That means that you're going to have some trials in the ministry. Yeah, everything is not going to be smooth sailing. Yes, Paul says when I started the journey, when I was on my sail and on my way to Rome, we started out, everything was smooth. But then after a while, the waters got rough. Anybody know what I'm talking about? You may come to Jesus and everything is smooth. But after a while and by and by, you're going to have some bumps in the road. You're going to have some violent experiences. Can I get a witness? Tell somebody we can't just be fair weather Christians. We got to be people of God no matter what. And so he says you're going to have some trials in the ministry. Listen to what he says here. Now, according to Pastoral Care, Inc., Pastor Care, Inc. says pastoring is a dangerous thing. Pastoring is a dangerous thing. Over 1,700 pastors a month left the pulpit last year.
Right.
Wow. Tell somebody that's a dangerous thing.
Dangerous thing.
90% of pastors are working between 55 and 75 hours a week. Tell somebody that's a dangerous thing.
That's a dangerous.
70% of pastors are fighting depression.
Right.
It's a dangerous thing. 70% rushing of pastors don't even have one person that they can call their friend.
Yes.
Can I get a witness here? But the biggest danger in pastoring is the people of God not following leadership.
Yeah.
I feel God up in here. Isn't God all right? Regardless of how dangerous the ministry gets, you got to say like Paul, I shall not be moved. I am devoted to my call. Paul had some trials. He has some dangers. I don't know if you ever read his resume. Paul's resume sounds something like this. 5 times I was beaten 39 stripes. 3 times I was beaten with rods. 1 time I was stoned. Is it God all right? Yeah. 3 times I was shipwrecked. I was always in perils. I was hungry. I fasted. I was naked. I was cold. And beside all of these things, I carried with me the care of the church. And I'm here to tell you, listen, he said, if pastoring was a job, we would have been quit that job. Can I get a witness up in here? If pastoring was a job, if you thought we did it just for the money, maybe we would have been quit. But I heard Paul say, woe unto me. Our necessity is laid upon me. Woe unto me if I preach not the gospel of Jesus Christ. Tell somebody I can't help it. He can't help it. He's got to do what God has called him to do. If he's not pressing, you might as well take him on out and lay him down in the cemetery. Is it God all right? But he said, listen, you are obligated to stay true to your calling. Is it God all right? Always have for your alma mater that old Negro spiritual that said, I shall not be moved. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I shall not be moved. I'm like a tree planted by the rivers of waters. I shall not be moved. Come on, somebody point towards your pastor and say, Pastor, be devoted to your calling. Is it God all right? But then he had another piece of advice. He said, neither count I my life dear unto myself. In other words, he's saying, devalue your life. He's not saying, don't think of yourself as unimportant, because you are God's gift. But he wants you to know it can't ever, 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 and it can't ever, 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 ever be about you. Can I get a witness here? Yeah, you cannot count your life so valuable that you choose your own interests over God's ministry. We must be willing to lay down our life. How many now know tonight that your life does not belong to you? But you have been bought with a price. Can I get a witness? You've been redeemed. Not with corruptible things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Jesus. Come on, tell someone, I have been redeemed. I like the way Paul says it in Galatians 2 and 20. I've been crucified with Christ, but nevertheless I live. But it's not I that liveth, but it's Christ that lives on the inside.
Yeah, yeah.
So when they talk about you, say that's all right, because I am in good company. They talk about Jesus.
Yeah.
And when you have haters hating on you, you say that's all right, I'm still in good company, because they hated Jesus. Isn't God all right? We have been bought with a price. In other words, he said, devalue your life. Your life is a living sacrifice.
Yeah.
It is to be holy and acceptable unto God, which is
reasonable.
Your reasonable service.
Yeah.
Isn't God all right? I got one more piece here, and I got to run to my seat. He says now the reason why, yes, I want to be able to finish my course with joy. Isn't God all right? And somebody shout, Pastor, you need to celebrate your destiny. Isn't God a good God? I'm about to tell you that you got a real good destiny. And although the adversary is working hard to keep you from completing your destiny, I stop by to tell you and to remind you that he cannot win. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, the devil can't win. Is it God all right? Is it all right? Is it all right? He tried to against Moses' destiny by killing all the young kids. But I'm here to tell you, he did not win. Isn't God all right? But the best example is he tried to win against Jesus. Isn't God all right? And I stop by to tell you that he could not win. Isn't God all right? He had Jesus out in the wilderness. Shame if thou be the Son of God. Command that these stones be made bread? Is it God our right? But I heard Jesus say, man shall not live by bread alone. Is it God our right? That's why when I don't have no food in my cupboard, I still got a cupboard full. Because man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Is it God all right? When they tried to defeat him, what they ended up doing is praying in his hand. Is it God all right? I'm here to tell you, Russian, when folk try to do you wrong, they can't hurt you. They just plain into your hand. Is it God all right? Somebody say yes. I say yes. 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 When he suffered, there was plain in his hand. Because it should have been you, and it should have been me. But I heard Isaiah say he was wounded. Yeah, he approves from my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon him, and by his stripes we'll be made whole. Somebody say yes. I'll say yes. They tried to stop him, not crucify him, but they played it in his hand. Is it God all right? When they put him out there, they made a mistake. They should have kept him on the ground, because I heard Jesus say, If I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. Is it God all right? Somebody say yes. Say yes. Yes. While we were staying out there, I heard the Lord say, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. They pierced him in the side, nails in his hands, and found a bush around his head, nails in his feet. But how many bad? Full of blood, full of blood, full of blood of Jesus. Give your neighbor a high five and say, neighbor, there's power. Thank you. English to the end of the journey.
Right. Tell them, Reverend.
Give me a shout right now.
Right now.
Give me something right now.
Right now.
Give me a neighbor high five and leave me
something.
Why you celebrating?
Celebrate.
See that Paul said.
Celebrate.
I fought a good fight. And I finished.
Yes, sir.
My course.
I kept the faith.
And I have kept the faith.
Yes, sir.
And henceforth,
it's laid up for me.
It's laid up for me.
A crown of righteousness.
A crown of righteousness.
Yeah. Which the righteous is. My.
I can celebrate that now. Is it God all right? Every now and then,
yeah.
You got to fast forward.
Yes.
And see what the end is going to be. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. Celebrate. Celebrate your destiny. One day, you're going to say, Russian brother, my good and faithful servant.
Yes.
Well done.
Well done.
He's been faithful on a few things.
Well done, but I'm going to make you ruler over many.
Is a God a good God?
Yes.
All over the house of God, come on, stand to your feet and give him a praise. Let me just come and talk.